الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We continue with some of the hadith of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام from the book of الترغيب والترهيب by Imam المنذري رحمه الله. The virtue of reciting the Quran in the Salah and outside of the Salah, and the virtue of learning the Quran and teaching the Quran, and also with the sujood of التلاوة. And the last thing we talked about was the permissible hasad, which is ghibta, that only in two things it is permissible for a person to wish to have if he sees it on someone else without that other person to lose it. Otherwise, it becomes evil, major sin. But even without wishing to lose it from the other side, it's only permissible in two cases. Someone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, gave him the Quran, so he is implementing it day and night, not just given the Quran to recite it or to memorize it, but he's acting according to the Quran. And someone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, gave him wealth that he makes sadaqah, that his benefit is extended to others by his wealth. These are the two cases that it's permissible for a Muslim, if he sees someone like that, first of all, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless whatever he gave that Muslim, and then to wish that you can have the same so that you would do the same. Anything else, it's not permissible even to wish. Once that wishing feeling comes in place, push it away. Remember that this dunya, this life, is a temporary one, and everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What matters is what stays forever, with al amal al salih. Then after that, the next authentic hadith in the list is the hadith of Abdullah ibn Amr radiallahu anhu. He said, أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الصيام والقرآن يشفعان للعبد يقول الصيام رب إني منعته الطعام والشراب بالنهار فشفعني فيه ويقول القرآن رب منعته النوم بالليل فشفعني فيه فيشفعان. So this hadith reported by Imam Ahmad and others, and it's an authentic hadith that both الصيام and the Quran, they make shafa'ah, they intercede with the person in the day of judgment. And we talked about the shafa'ah. Al-shaf' is even and al-watr is odd. So yashfa', that means he becomes with the individual in the day of judgment to protect him. That Muslim is not alone. He has the siyam and the Quran with him to defend him, to intercede for him, to be means for him to have the sins forgiven, to enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-siyam will say in the day of judgment, Rabbi, my Lord, إني منعته الطعام والشراب بالنار. My Lord, I deprived him. I withhold him from eating and drinking during the day. That's what الصيام. And that's why من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا. Believing that this is from Allah and seeking reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فشفعني فيه. So, oh Allah, make me intercede for him. Make me defend him because he stayed away from eating and drinking during the day of the while he's fasting. And the Quran will say, رَبِّ مَنَعْتُهُ النَّوْمَ بِاللَّيْلِ. And we have to pay attention to the words here because this is going to happen in the day of judgment. The Quran would say, my Lord, I prevented him from sleeping at night. So we have to make sure that we have something to do with the Quran at night. And especially as you see in Ramadan, Taraweeh, when someone complains, there's work, there's this and that, it's meant to be this way. The sacrifice that when your schedule changes and you sleep less during the month of Ramadan, especially these nights, remember that this is means of intercession. And it doesn't have to be that you're the one that is reciting in the Salah, because as we said, the Quran in the Salah is more virtue than any other time when it comes to the Quran. So the same thing applies for Salatul Fajr. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran of Salatul Fajr. وَقُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ إِنَّ قُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ كَانَ مَشْهُودًا. The Quran of Al-Fajr, because indeed the Quran of Al-Fajr, and it's repeated twice to show the importance. مَشْهُودًا, that means it witnessed by the angels. What is Quran al-Fajr? Is the Quran recited in Salatul Fajr. So that's why when you're a person behind the Imam listening to the Quran of Salatul Fajr, even if he doesn't understand what is being recited, this has an effect in the heart. This is the blessings of Salatul Fajr is also something that we cannot really imagine. لو يعلم الناس ما في العتمة والفجر لأتوهما ولو حبوا. As the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, if people know what's in Salatul Fajr and Salatul Isha, they will come to it even if they have to crawl on their faces. So those who are busy with the Quran, and for the youth, where are you in Salatul Fajr? People need to be in Salatul Fajr in the masjid. So this is part of that, that a person would deprive himself from some sleep. By what? Because of the Quran. The Quran called him, the Quran commanded him. And with the night prayer. فَشَفِّعْنِي فِي. So Allah, make me intercede for him. فَيُشَفَّعَان. So they both will be intercede, they will be allowed to intercede for the person. الصيام والقرآن. The next hadith, عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه. أن أسيد بن حضير بينما هو ليلة يقرأ في مربده. أسيد بن حضير, one of the companions of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, while he was in one night reading the Quran. And again, the portion of the Quran that you would read at night has a different effect than when you read it during the day. So at least even have something, even three verses, even anything of the Quran that you would recite during the night. So he was reading at one night in mirbadihi. Al-mirbad is the place where they put the tamr, the dates, to get dry. So he was, sitting there and reading Quran at night. إِذْ جَالَتْ فَرَسُهُ. His horse start moving in an abnormal way. ثُمَّ جَالَتْ أُخْرَى. Then it happened again. فَقَرَأْ. فَقَرَأْ. So he kept on reciting. When he recited, the faras starts moving. The khail, the horse start moving. So he recited again. So it start moving again. ثُمَّ جَالَتْ أَيْضًا. قَالَ أُسَيْدْ. فَخَشِيْتُ أَنْ تَطَأَ يَحْيَى. He said, I was afraid that it would step on Yahya. Yahya, his son, was close by. He was afraid that the horse would step on his son. He said, فَقُمْتُ إِلَيْهَا. So I stood up to it. فَإِذَا مِثْلُ الظُّلَّةِ فَوْقَ رَأْسِي فِيهَا أَمْثَالُ السُّرُجِ عُرِجَتْ فِي الْجَوِّ حَتَّى مَا أَرَهَا. When he stood up to see, he saw that on top of the horse, there was a dhullah, or something like a shade or a canopy or something of that nature, with suruj, with lights in it, and it kept on ascending to the heavens. So something like a dhullah, something like how the umbrella is, and it has lights in it, and it kept on then ascending to the heavens. It was right on top of the horse. So he said, فَغَدَوْتُ عَلَى رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. Said, I went to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Al-ghudu is when someone goes in the morning. So he did not go immediately to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. He went to the morning to the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَقُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ بَيْنَمَا أَنَا الْبَارِحَ فِي جَوْفِ اللَّيْلِ. While I am, al-bariha is the night before the day that you're in. When you say last night, this is al-bariha. While I was in the bariha, in the middle of the day. Again, in the middle of the night. And the best time for salah at night is the middle of the night. And the best time for dua is the last part of the night. But whatever easy, if a person can, even in the beginning of the night is always virtue with the Quran. He says, while I was reciting the Quran, في مربدي, in my place, where he dried the dates, إِذْ جَالَتْ فَرَسِي, what he narrated to the Prophet ﷺ what happened. So the Prophet ﷺ, he said to him, اقرأ ابن حضير. He said, recite, read, O Ibn Hudayr. قال فقرأت ثم جالت أيضا فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم اقرأ ابن حضير. He did that, so it did the same thing. And the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام told him three times to do the same. He said, فانصرفت وكان يحيى قريبا منها خشيت أن تطأه فرأيت مثل الظل. This is continued with the same duration. Then he said, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, what did he tell him? He said, تلك الملائكة كانت تستمع لك. The angels, they were listening to you. ولو قرأت لأصبحت يراها الناس. And if you kept on reciting, the people would have seen that in the morning. ما تستتر منهم. Would not be hidden from them. And the hadith is in Al-Bukhari Muslim. So this is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows for these types of things sometimes to show. But it's a continuous thing that is happening when it comes to the sakinah, to the tranquility that descends, to the rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So all of that is present at all times if a person would recite the Quran. And once in a while, things can that happen for people to see with their own eyes. We'll take two more hadith, inshallah ta'ala. The next one is عن أنس رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن لله أهلين من الناس قالوا من هم يا رسول الله قال أهل القرآن هم أهل الله وخاصته. And this is an authentic hadith. The hadith says إن لله أهلين. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed are أهلين. الأهل, what is الأهل? For you as a human being is your family, right? Your closest ones. Al-ahl is the closest ones to you, the ones that your allies, your supporters, the ones that are with you, right? And that basically the ahl. If you need something, they'll be there for you without any return. So the hadith says to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are ahleen, there are ahl to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means the closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Min al-nas, from the people. قالوا من هم يا رسول الله؟ Who are they, O Messenger of Allah? The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, أهل القرآن هم أهل الله وخاصته. أهل القرآن. So the people of the Quran. And with all what that means. And أهل القرآن, it means those who are their life is about the book of Allah, the Quran. With all of the rights of the Quran. Reciting, memorizing, understanding, acting upon the Quran. And as we heard in the other hadiths before, يقومون بالليل والنهار. During the night, they stand in salah. During the day, they implement what they are reciting, implementing the Quran in their life. So these are the people of the Quran. They are the people of Allah. وخصته, that means they are the most special and closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One last hadith, inshallah ta'ala, which is the hadith for the virtue of having also one's children to memorize the Quran. And this hadith is حسن لغيره. عن بريدة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قرأ القرآن وتعلمه وعمل به. But this is it's not the, before I say the hadith, we think that it's only about memorizing the Quran. Memorizing the Quran is very virtue, and it should be. That's why those who are young, before they get older, becomes difficult. If we have the means to every single child, once they are 7, 8, once they're able, and the Sheikh would tell you exactly the best age for them to start memorizing the Quran, everybody should memorize the Quran. All these children. And this is how the early generations used to do for their children, to give the best gift for your child. Even guidance is in the hands of Allah. But when they are under your control and that you're able to give them this, then they'll be blessed by it, inshallah ta'ala, later. And Quran protects them by the will of Allah. But the point here is, with conditions. This is the first step. Once a person memorizes the Quran, this is the first step that follows, not the end of things. He says, "Man qara'a," pay attention to the words of the hadith, inshallah. Whoever recites the Quran, وَتَعَلَّمَهُ وَعَمِلَ بِهِ, and learned it. Recite and learned the Quran, وَعَمِلَ بِهِ, and acted upon it. So with these conditions, what's the reward? أُلْبِسَ وَالِدَاهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ تَاجًا مِنْ نُورٍ. His parents will wear in the day of Al-Qiyamah a crown from light. ضوءه مثل ضوء الشمس. Its light is like the light of the sun. ويكسى والداه حلتان لا تقوم لهما الدنيا. And his parents will, Al-Kiswa is the covering, is the garment that covers the person. حلتان. الحلة is the garment that is of two pieces, usually called الحلة. So, which is more perfect, the Arabs, when someone wears something two pieces, that means he's, mashallah, he's rich. So, حلتان, his parents will wear this. لا تقوم لهما الدنيا. The entire dunya cannot be even equal to these حلتان. Imagine the whole dunya, how much is one lot of land, how much is it? Imagine the entire dunya, how much worth it, worth money-wise. Then these two garments, the dunya and all whatever it contains, would not be equal to these hullatan. فَيَقُولَن. So the parents, when they see that happening to them, they will say, بِمَا كُسِينَ هَذَا. What reason we are being wearing these types of things? فَيُقَالْ بِأَخْذِي وَلَدِيكُمَ الْقُرْآنِ. Because of your son taking the Qur'an, having the Qur'an. So this is the blessings of the son. And the walad, by the way, if it's mentioned in the hadith, it includes both male and female. This is not because we're trying to twist things so that the females are happy. No, this is how the language is. Al-walad is ayu shay'in yulad, the one that is being born. Right? So even with the hadith, al-walad salih yad'u lak. One of the three things that is continuous after one's death is waladun salihun yad'u lak. Righteous walad makes dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you. Meaning, whatever you gave birth, men, women, it doesn't matter, as long as they are righteous. So, بِأَخْذِ وَلَدِكُمْ الْقُرْآنَ and the hadith, صحيح على شرط مسلم, and it's an authentic hadith, and حسن لغيري. One last thing with this, if the parents are having the means to it, mashallah, this is very obvious. But even if the parents don't have, or they did not take the means for it. So if you want to do a favor to your parents, and they didn't take you to memorize the Quran, you start memorizing the Quran. If you memorize the Quran, and you act upon the Quran, and even if a person is not able to memorize, very old in age, act upon the Quran and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. But the point here is the hadith doesn't say it's from the kasb or from the earnings of the parents only. It's about the action of the child. So if the child, even if he's a grown up, but he's a child for a parent, right? So the son or a daughter, if they memorize the Quran, part of the blessings, because this is Kitabu Mubarak, this is a blessed book. So the blessings get extended. So even if the parents didn't have the means, as long as they die in the state of Islam, they would receive this honor. And that's why some of the ulama, they say one of the things of birr, of righteousness to the parents, if you're a grown up, an adult, because you know how the children, they're dragged sometimes to these things, they don't understand, they don't seek rewards in these matters. But if you're an adult and you hear something like this, out of being righteous to your parents, whether they're alive or dead, start acting according to the Quran, be busy with the Quran, memorize the Quran for that reason, so that you will give that gift or become the means and the reasons for your parents to have this. So if this is to the parents, so how can then imagine the rewards to the individual that memorized the Quran? That's why, as we heard, one ayah is a level in Jannah. So virtue after virtue, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who are the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the people of the Quran. Again, as we said, من قرأ القرآن وتعلمه وعمل به. Whoever learned the Quran, recited the Quran and learned it and acted upon it. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those. صلى الله وسلم وبارك على محمد وصحبه وسلم.